Good afternoon, once again. So I am Jagdish Kulkarni from Yashwant Rao Chavan Maharashtra Open University. Our Open University was established in 1989, and from 1990 we have this audiovisual center. So this audiovisual setup is there for almost 20 years. In YCMU, that is Yashwant Rao. I hope you can see this. Chavan Maharashtra Open University. We have 10 schools, 10 academic schools, which include agriculture, computer, commerce and management, humanities, social science, then information technology, continuing education, health science, education, B.Ed. and like that. Okay, so we have 10 schools. So we make syllabus-based programs for these schools. Syllabus-based programs for all the schools. Initially, 20 years ago, in 1990, we had the format called Super VHS. And then we had high band, that was U-matic. Then we had beta cam, that is still there. Then DV cam, and we now have HDV cameras also now. Okay, and so we started with SVHS in 1990. And then 1994 high band, then beta cam, and so on. Initially, we were distributing the cassettes, VHS cassettes, to our students. At that time, in 1990, VHS players were more common. CDs were not available that time. After that, we started showing the programs on Doordarshan, Mumbai Doordarshan, because basically we work with Marathi students. So our programs were telecast from Doordarshan. From 2000 to 2006, we were telecasting on Doordarshan, and now we can even telecast on Doordarshan, that is not regular now, because we have got ISRO, that is ISRO VLC, the Virtual Learning Centers we have. So we have this network, and Girish, my colleague Girish, will be giving you the details of this network, and we also webcast. So right now, till now we have produced around 500 videos and around 500 audios. We also produce audio programs along with the video programs. We also produce audio programs, and our audio programs go on a radio. A new experiment was done by YCMU in 1990 and 1991. That was FM radio tech, FM radio techs. We had prepared radio programs, audio programs, which were broadcast on radio, FM radio, and along with that radio program, text message can be could be delivered to the other end. That was a new technology. At present, we have beta cam. We have 3 beta cameras, and then we have DV cam. We have 3 cameras again. And then for editing, we have a Final Cut Pro FCP. Again, that is the latest machine. And we have Media 100. Many people might not be knowing about this machine, but that was the old machine that was available with us. That was the first generation of non-linear editing machine. But we are working with editing from the cut-to-cut editing. From the basic editing now up to the latest possible editing. So we have experience on that also. Right now we give CDs, DVDs as per requirement, and then some of our programs go with ISRO network, that is virtual learning network, virtual learning classes, and then we also webcast, as I have told you. Now our new studio is coming up, that is first of its kind in Maharashtra, North Maharashtra I can say, and in which again the HDV format will be there. So Sir Budde sir had been there too, he was the expert for selecting this particular system. At this website, www.ycmuvirtuallearning.com, we have at this website, we have 30 video programs on the topic of environmental education. This subject is now compulsory for all second year students all over India, and all those videos are there are 30 videos, Marathi and English both, and all the videos are now on the available on the internet for freely downloading. I mean, something like open source, which is available everywhere. So there are two ways. First thing, there is a request from academician, academic center, or the academicians. The school gives us the request that this is the topic on which we want to produce the video. The video is necessary, and these are the points to be covered in the video, like that. So the content comes from them, and then it is decided whether the program will be online or it should be offline. Many times it is a combination of both. It is a combination of lecture plus graphics plus so many other visuals coming in, or many times it is just a documentary style, as you know, just documentary and some commentary to it. But then it is decided whether the program is online or offline. Then the person who will deliver the lecture or narrate is decided. Again, this suggestion is from naturally from the academic side. Okay, then there are so many ways that we are doing the program. One is lecture, of course. Another is discussion of or interview based. A documentary is there, that is, that will come under. Yeah, that will, the lecture is done in the classroom. Then there are interviews. Then there are outdoor interviews that we basically use for agriculture. Demonstration lectures are there, but many times we try to bring the apparatus in the same studio. But actually, and in there is one format that we have tried, that is dramatization. And we have many programs on this format, many programs. We have tried to dramatize the thing, you know, and then show it. Yeah, we have done it many times. Many times we have done that. Many programs are in Marathi. All these dramatized programs are basically in Marathi, very rarely in English. But we have done that also. So there are various formats that we use, a production format. And in post-production, the lecture, interview, they generally go straight with some addition of graphics or like that, with cutting, I mean, whatever we want to edit, there are some mistakes, so we want to value add something, then that is done. But as far as the outdoor shooting or interviews are concerned, then that has to be re-edited, and proper visuals and graphics and many things are added. Then that thing is previewed by the academicians, it is finalized, and then it is released for maybe CD, DVD or whatever. We have the online studio. As I said, we have three camera, Betacam, three Betacamera setup. So these three cameras are fed to the vision mixer switcher, and then that is recorded on DV or Beta. So this is the circuit. If you want to see the, I mean, very circuit diagrams, three cameras. Those are connected by composite video cable at present to a switcher. Then there is some other input which can come from DV cam or any other camera or a VTR. Right now we have a small DV tips. And nowadays we are also using computer. Because many times the lecturer brings in, not for the capture, basically for PowerPoints. Many times the lecturer brings in the PowerPoint and other things, you know, or PDF or something like that. So that has to be shown. So the computer also is connected to switcher. So this input is there to the switcher, and then composite out is fed to VTR, main master VTR, Betacam or DVCam. We use both actually, Betacam or DVCam, and that is recorded at the when there is live telecast, it is fed to ISRO telecasting network. Basically, our job is to shoot, edit, I mean, or online edit or offline edit, and feed it to the ISRO network. So from there it is broadcast to the VLCs.
What do you do for the audio?
Yeah, audio mic, we have 7 or 8 microphones, and then
so
that audio goes to audio mixer. In post production, so this is online, okay, this is all, this is online, okay, and then then we have 2 editing machines, one is FCP and another is Media 100. Generally we do it on Betacam. When the offline editing editing has to be done, we work with Betacam because that is a better option. So Betatef is directly fed with component input to FCP or Media 100, whatever machine you choose. We have 2 machines, and then in FCP the editing is done, and from FCP again it comes on Beta for storage, and DVCam for multi-copying. Multi-copying is done according to needs. Many times it is done on VCDs, many times it is done on DVDs, or even for this webcasting we now take a copy it on DVCam only.